This morning, support is growing for Kate Middleton from around the globe after that shock announcement that she's receiving treatment for cancer. Live now to Nine Europe correspondent Edward Godfrey, who's outside Buckingham Palace for us. Edward, the UK is uniting behind the Princess of Wales.
Yeah, it is, Jane. Our reaction to the Princess's message has been huge here at Buckingham Palace. Large crowds have been flowing through here all day long. And look, that is not out of the ordinary, but the mood has been noticeably different. Similar scenes at Kensington Palace too, not far from where we are. Some people leaving flowers, lots of crowds hanging about there, chatting about what's happening. One of the bouquets of flowers that we saw left at the gate there just on its own had a message scrawled on it saying, "Get well soon." At Windsor, there have been thousands of visitors there. Now, that is a very popular spot for tourists and for keen royal watchers. But once again, the mood was very different. Many people there have been wondering for so long what's been going on with Kate. They were there talking about it, even coming up to us, asking lots of questions, wanting to know anything more about her situation. Many there clearly affected by the princess's message in that video, which came out last night, our time. And we spoke with some of those there.
I thought it was really sad. You know, I think people kind of wanted to know what was going on, but certainly didn't expect to be hearing that.
No, she certainly deserves her privacy, especially with small children.
I think they should be left alone as a family to deal with it.
At the end of the day, she's a human being, and it's going to be just as hard for her as it would be for anybody else.
To see her sitting on her own, that took some courage.
A special place, that one there. It is within the Windsor grounds there where the Prince and Princess of Wales live inside Adelaide Cottage. Kate now taking longer than planned away from royal public duties. When she first went into hospital, the palace said she'd be back around Easter time, maybe just after Easter. That's certainly not expected to happen now. Meanwhile, palace sources, Jane, say that King Charles, who's got his own cancer battle, is planning or hoping to attend an Easter Sunday service along with Queen Camilla. It's understood that will be a much smaller royal family turnout than usual. That's to minimise his contact with others. He is undergoing cancer treatment, of course, and his immune system would be compromised. Jane?
Edward, thank you.
Welcome back. It's the cancer diagnosis that shocked the world. And this morning we're hearing more about how the royal family is rallying around Kate Middleton as she begins her treatment.
We're joined now by former BBC royal commentator Jenny Bond, live from Devon in the UK. Good morning to you again, Jenny.
Hi, Jenny.
It's now been just over 24 hours since the news broke. What is the feeling like in the UK tonight, your time?
Well, I think it's been a day here of reflection on all that this family is going through and have been going through, unbeknownst to most of us. And I think a certain amount of soul searching by the social media trolls who put about all those rumours. One or two commentators have come forward and apologised for joining in that speculation. And as you say, the family of Catherine and of William have been rallying around. William's uncle, Earl Spencer, Diana's brother, posted a picture of the princess and spoke of her incredible strength and her poise. And Catherine's own brother, James Middleton, put up a lovely picture of the two of them when they were children and said, we've climbed many mountains together and as a family, we will climb this one. So there's a great feeling of everyone rallying around the princess. And honestly, she's really gone in the past week from not exactly villain, but last weekend we were all talking about the picture which had been edited and, you know, what a stupid thing to do. And this weekend, she is the absolute heroine, the lion of the UK, yeah, as one of the papers has put it.
There you go. Mm. Yeah, that news really starting to sink in now, a day and a half for that to happen. King Charles has been very brave through all of this as well and very proud of what Kate's done. He'll lead the royals on Easter Sunday in support of Kate. How important is this for him to do that?
Yeah, it's quite a big deal. I don't think, well, we absolutely did not expect the King to be at the traditional Easter Sunday service. There's usually a big turnout of royals for that. There will be few of them, by definition almost, this Easter, because we know that the Waleses aren't going to go along. They're elsewhere at the moment. But the King has apparently every intention of being there with a smaller congregation. Of course, the problem for him is not so much the treatment and the cancer he's undergoing, but the fact that that treatment can compromise your immune system. And so he needs to not be mingling with huge crowds. But that can be very contained, that service. It is essentially a private service. So it would be great if he gets to go there.
Now, Jenny, we are hearing that Meghan and Harry only learned this news at the same time as the rest of us. We did see Harry make the trip back to the UK when Charles announced his cancer diagnosis. Is there any chance that this could lead to a family reunion?
Well, reunion, I suppose, is a possibility. Mending of the rift between the brothers, I think not. Mm. I think that William has got so much on his plate at the moment, so much, that he is utterly focused on the recovery of his wife, the care of his children, and the care of his father as well. I do not think he has time to deal with, you know, several years now of bitter acrimony between himself and his brother. It would be great if Harry did come over. I don't suppose they would turn him away, but I just don't think it's something that William has the emotional strength to deal with at the moment. I don't think he should be asked to do so.
Yeah. Well, we know that Harry and Meghan wished health and healing for Kate, and that they can do that privately and in peace. Anyway, there you go. We know you're a very busy woman these last couple of days. Jenny, thanks so much for making time for us.
More now on Kate Middleton's cancer revelation. With news this morning, the King plans to return to the spotlight on Easter Sunday in a public show of support for the Princess of Wales.
Let's bring in Royal Editor at the Daily Mirror, Russell Myers. Russell, g'day, good to see you. The Royal Family really rallying around Kate.
Yeah, you're right, Alex. Good morning, guys. I mean, you know, this is absolutely devastating news for the Princess of Wales yesterday. So opening up, talking about her cancer diagnosis, the fact she's undergoing chemotherapy treatment at the moment. But short of form, the Royal Family are pulling all the stops out to get around Kate, give her their love and support, and no more so than the King, because, you know, he's got his own cancer battle ongoing at the moment, been receiving weekly treatment for a few weeks now after confirming his cancer in early February. But he's going to plan to sort of put on a show of unity, put on a show of support, not only for Kate, but the rest of the royal family at Easter Sunday. And I think it's about showing that the monarchy is stable. It's all good, sort of, even if the two main players are missing in action. But good on the King and good on the rest of the family for supporting her.
Yeah.
Well, we've all had about 24 hours now to digest this news of Kate's cancer treatment. How is that news being received in the UK? What's the feeling there right now?
Well, it's not just the UK. I think, you know, everybody's felt it throughout the world. And, you know, Princess of Wales has been missing out of public life for quite a while. And we've had these crazy conspiracy theories over the last few weeks. You know, they've been outlandish, they've been hurtful. And people at the palace have said to me, you know, the princess and the prince of Wales are not immune to this. You know, they're human people too. They do understand that there's an interest in their lives, but it has been absolutely out of control. And I think people are sort of hurting for Kate, and hopefully she'll be given the sort of rest and recovery and the privacy that she's asked for over these next few weeks and months.
Yeah, out of control is a good way to put it. Celebrities now, Rusty, they're coming out and apologising over that online speculation around Kate. We saw Blake Lively. Mm. She digitally altered one of her photos and she's come out apologising, egg on face for her. Was that all a little bit too insensitive? Should they be apologising?
Yeah, I think so. You know, not just the celebrities. I think a lot of people need to look at their conduct over the last few weeks. I mean, these conspiracy theories about Kate's treatment, the reason why she had surgery, the reason why she was taking a leave of absence, have gone absolutely ballistic. And it's been very, very hurtful. I mean, people are making money off of this as well, getting millions of views on social media. They're very ill-informed. And I think, you know, society needs to take a look at itself as well. You know, the social media trolls have ruled the roost, unfortunately, with this story. And now, hopefully, that the Princess of Wales has come out, said what's wrong with her, said that she's going to be taking an extended time away from the spotlight. Hopefully, everything can calm down and she'll be given that time to rest and recuperate.
Well, part of the reason that speculation ran rampant is because there was no information coming from the palace. Do you think they could have handled the situation better, or do you think it was just a case of wanting privacy?
Well, I think it's a double-edged sword, certainly. Right from the beginning, we heard from Kensington Palace, didn't we? And they said that the princess did not want to discuss her medical ailment. She wanted that to remain private. And certainly that is, you know, had been the case. But it's the case that I think the institution let her down, really, because there was this void. There was that void that needed to be filled in certain quarters. I'll be talking about the social media trolls getting out of control. But I think when one of the most famous people in the world is gone sort of missing from public life, I think that is an unfortunate circumstance that the palace didn't get ahead of. And now that she's come out and spoken, hopefully that will all be put to bed. And then, of course, we have the issue of her private medical records allegedly being accessed. And that was a big issue, not only for the princess, but for the palace. But hopefully things were going to start to calm down from now on. Mm.
And Russell, perhaps that's because this is unprecedented. We've got two leading figures in the royal family struck down with cancer, the king and now the princess. The queen, Elizabeth II, dying not long ago. This is unprecedented. Where to for the royal family from here?
Well, gosh, I mean, if I had a crystal ball, you couldn't have predicted anything over the last few weeks, let alone the last few years. I mean, we are in very uncharted and unprecedented times. And I think the world looks very different from a few months ago, even a few weeks ago. And you've got the two, you know, superstars of the royal family, the King and the Princess of Wales, now taking time out, now facing their own cancer battles. And spare a thought for Prince William as well, not only dealing with his father's condition, but his wife's as well, three young children at home. He's got a lot on his shoulders. And I think, you know, it's time to take a bit of a break for Easter. Then obviously the family are going to come back together and hopefully they'll have a plan moving forward.
Yeah.
Well, the good thing for them is they will be getting the very best medical care the world has to offer. So, you know,
definitely,
they're in a good position in that way.
Age is on her side too. Mm. All right, Rusty, thanks so much for being with us. We know you're a busy man and thanks for making time for us.